Title action upcoming. Looking to be a double champion, Desmond Alvarado. He's the 135-pound rising star champ. Looking to make history to become the only two-divisional consecutive champion as he takes on Daniel Labastida.
Yeah, there should be a great fight. Both these guys are extremely evenly matched.
UNF fans, get ready for another Rising Stars title bout. And please welcome our fighter from the blue corner, Daniel Labastida.
Daniel Labastida, El Heron, which means the ferret, because in camp, gentlemen, he said, you know, this guy's tough to get a hold of. He's very cagey. He's very resilient. You know, but he settled on the ferret because he didn't want to be known as the weasel, which was the original plan of action. But here's a guy that is just one of the most unique characters I think we've ever come across in Up Next Fighting.
Yesterday during the ceremonial weigh-ins, the Schmo tried to get this man to engage, to talk with his opponent. But no, a man of few words, he's a silent assassin, he's humble, and he's all about the action inside the cage.
Yeah, we've given this kid every opportunity to talk smack, and his prediction for the fight was both fighters are going to go home to their families proud and safe. Labastida weighed in 124.4 pounds, 5'5" tall. He's 25 years of age, training at Axe Academy and Pugilist MMA. In his corner, Rage NG, Rodrigo Carvalho, and Cameron Fardad, who we saw victorious in his fight earlier this evening.
Yeah, wants that recognition, thinks he's the best in this weight class, a chance to prove it. Although you have his opponent who's coming down from 135 here to the flyweight division. And Labastida has got a couple UNF fights under his belt, including most recently a unanimous decision win over Hung Nguyen at Club UNF, looking to ride that momentum. But again, interesting character. Showed up at content day in a Sith robe, and then when asked if he was a big Star Wars fan, he simply said no.
Very colorful personality, very dynamic fighter. He's got excellent wrestling, very powerful slams. Can't wait to see him inside there with Desmond Alvarado.
And his opponent out of the red corner, Desmond Alvarado.
Desmond Alvarado looking to prove to be the real deal here. Schmo looking to be a double champ, two different weight classes. He's already got the 135 Rising Stars title, looking to be a belt collector.
Looking to make some UNF history right here. We have that California state title on the line as well. Love what he's coming out to. This guy is cool, calm, collected, and he is ready for action. And that's a great song choice, by the way, too.
Yeah, and you know, that's a great point too. Looking to be, you know, to double down here with UNF titles, but in essence, looking for the trifecta because yes, of course, the California state flyweight title on the line as well. Jonathan, we look at the stats, a perfect 5-0 for those wins right here in UNF.
Yeah, he weighed 123.8 pounds. That's notable because he came under the limit for a 135 pounder. He said his cut went great. 5'6" tall, 66 inches of reach, 25 years of age, training out of CMMA. His dad is also in his corner tonight. Brown belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. This should be a great, great fight.
Take a look at Labastida just chilling over there in the corner.
He's singing the song of his opponent's walkout.
Very, very interesting demeanor prior to a fight. He is calm, he's relaxed.
El Heron absolutely marches to the beat of his own drum. But for Alvarado, it's been so impressive here at Up Next Fighting. Four victories, including a round three sub over Michael Salinas, decision wins over Kevin Lizardo, Ken Fajardo, an impressive TKO win over Rayshon Roland. Nobody's been able to stop this guy. Will it be Labastida?
You know, it could be. If he utilizes that wrestling tonight, it could be a long night for Desmond Alvarado. But let's talk about Alvarado for a second. He is calm. He is cool. He's collected. He reminds me of a very young Nick Diaz. Nothing seems to flap this guy inside the cage. He seems to have a fighter's mentality, and he's an extremely aggressive cat. I cannot wait to see these guys touch gloves and throw down.
UNF fans, this bout is presented by Nazo Boxing. The fighters are ready. The cage is set. Let's go! This fight is set for 3 rounds for the UNF Rising Stars flyweight title and the California State flyweight championship. Your referee in charge, Mike Bell. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, fighting his fifth fight tonight, standing at 5'5", weighing in at 124.4 pounds. Representing Axie Academy and Pugilist, and fighting out of Simi Valley, California, Daniel Alvarado Labastida. And his opponent out of the red corner, he is undefeated with 5 victories, standing at 5'6", weighing in at 123.8 pounds. Representing CMMA and fighting on a Whittier, California, Desmond Alvarado.
All right, gentlemen, you got your instructions backstage. Protect yourself all the time, so obey my commands all the time. If you want to touch gloves, do it now. Best of luck to both of you.
Mutual respect between the 135 champion Desmond Alvarado and challenger for the 125 crown, as well as his opponent and challenger Daniel Labastida. Labastida, a very unique character, but brings in a great skill set, both very comfortable on the ground. And Labastida trying to get it there early.
You know, he certainly reached for that takedown, but able to bring the fight into the clinch here. Alvarado defending well.
And Alvarado very comfortable when it comes to jiu-jitsu. His family ran a jiu-jitsu academy. It's been a way of life for as long as he can remember. Nice throw by the undefeated Alvarado, looking for a guillotine.
Loving these scrambles, gentlemen, loving the scrambles.
Labastida in on a single here. Let's see if he can connect his hands as he tries to parlay that into a double leg. But he's on both knees. It's tough to finish a takedown when you give up your vertical base.
Working hard for it here. And Alvarado, so impressive with that hip toss earlier, was going for it again. Alvarado is so physically dominant, he's got Labastida up against the cage.
Labastida trying to angle with his feet here to create a trip here.
And very good head pressure you're seeing from Alvarado against Labastida against the cage.
Labastida, though, circles out, and he's got some power as well. At one point had Alvarado off his feet up against the cage, jockeying for position, human game of chess. Who's going to get the better of this?
Alvarado in deep again as Alvarado defends. Alvarado looking to get an underhook here, reverses position.
Both thinking the same thing there, both trying to pull the trigger with the knee, and now Labastida going deep for a takedown attempt again. Single leg, can he complete it? Oh man, look at that control of the arm by Alvarado.
Yeah, Alvarado doing a great job of using that leg to control the arm of Labastida. We'll see if he can spin off the back here and try to get to a dominant position, but Labastida preventing that by staying relentless in pursuit of that takedown.
Well, Schmo, round and round they go.
Absolutely relentless, will not give up that single leg attempt. He is doing everything in his power to bring this fight to the mats.
But if he doesn't complete it, I mean, how much time and effort and energy is being expelled here by Daniel Labastida?
You know, he's certainly investing heavy on this approach here. But, you know, Labastida's got a gas tank on him, so I don't think he's going to tire, especially in this first frame.
Inside half a minute to go now in our first of 3 rounds. Both the Rising Stars title in the flyweight division, California state title on the line. Alvarado looking to make history, become the first double champion here in UNF. Only seconds to go now in the first round. First round comes to a close. Great action throughout. Schmo, we'll start with you, your thoughts.
Well, the unofficial Schmo card right here is, yes, Labastida had all the pressure, but it was Alvarado who was able to land the strikes. He was able to defend himself from getting taken to the ground, and there was just a lot of pressure being applied. Schmo gives the edge to Alvarado, but it'll be interesting to see how the judges sway these things.
Jonathan, your thoughts after a round that had more scramble than a Denny's?
Yeah, I definitely agree with Schmo on that one. I think Alvarado had the more effective strikes. He had the submission attempt, and he also defended those takedowns well. Let's see if he's able to parlay that into the second round and see what he can do with it. But Labastida is definitely in this fight.
Labastida invested heavy in that takedown, and it just didn't pay dividends, but we'll see what round two holds.
And we know he'll probably try to employ a similar strategy, but how much juice is left in those arms? Where's the fatigue factor going to be as this second round marches on?
Two titles on the line. Time to fight on here at Up Next Fighting. Round two in this double title flyweight clash. Alvarado on the left of your screen against Daniel Labastida.
Oh, he got caught there. Labastida throwing reckless abandon here, but not landing anything.
Trying to turn this thing into a brawl. I don't know if that's going to favor El Jaron. Going for broke.
Again, trying to get the fight to the mat. Labastida investing seriously heavy on this takedown attempt. His game plan is evident. He's trying to bring the fight to the mat where he thinks he can finish Alvarado, but Alvarado seems to be a very tough out to bring to the mat.
Alvarado is just so strong, and Labastida going for it again, but now we'll see who gets the better of this scramble. Alvarado's just so powerful. Looking for it again. Alvarado ends up on top. Labastida might pay for this takedown attempt here, guys. Right back to that head pressure, as you mentioned earlier, Schmo, really grinding and making Labastida pay the price.
And certainly. Now, if you're Labastida, you got to use this cage to get your hips in check, and you got to work your way up as much as you can. But this is interesting now, because here you have Alvarado working to take the back of Labastida, and now they're standing, working for a tie clinch. If you're Alvarado, you try to separate, you try to get these two to stand and bang.
Oh, he landed a nice left-right combination. Alvarado's starting to swarm here.
Speaking of standing and banging, some big shots there by Alvarado, who's looking for a takedown of his own now. Looking to lower levels. But those are some big, meaningful shots by Alvarado.
Beautiful job lacing the leg with his own and bringing the fight back to the mat. Alvarado in full mount now.
Alvarado so strong, and now look at this, just smothering Labastida, making things very uncomfortable for El Jaron.
Got to get those elbows mixed in there, short punches. You got to really get Labastida to scramble and think about how he's going to defend his dome and get out of this.
Under a minute to go now in our second of three rounds. Nice transition there by the undefeated Desmond Alvarado.
Chest to back pressure very heavy here for Alvarado as Labastida fights his way back. Ooh. To a vertical base. Nice shoulder stroke out of Conor McGregor there.
Got him right on the butt, right on the chin there. And I mean, this has got to be exhausting if you're Labastida. I mean, you just can't catch a breath. Final seconds of the second round now ticking away. And in exchange to close out the round, more great stuff by Alvarado against a very tough Labastida. Gentlemen, your thoughts after one. Jonathan, let's start with you this time.
I have Desmond Alvarado in firm control, 2-0, 20-18. Alvarado cruising right now.
All right, who had more schmoments in that one?
I would definitely go with Alvarado. Here we take a look at the replay. He was swarming there. He wasn't able to get anything substantial. Here he's trying to grapple. You get Alvarado on top. He separates. He's able to land some shots, land some knees, and I think he got the best of him in that round.
There you have it. And so that being said, does Labastida find himself in a position where he needs a finish if he's going to win this fight and take home the title?
Either that or a 10-8 for a draw, but, you know, I have Alvarado, like Schmo said, I have him winning the Schmoments, if you will.
Again, the undefeated Desmond Alvarado looking to make history. He's the 135 Rising Stars champion. He's looking to do the same here in the flyweight division and win a state title as well. High stakes here at Commerce Casino in our third and final round.
Let's see what adjustments Labastida's made in the corner as he walks right into a left hand there from Alvarado. Alvarado again in on a takedown, looking for the high crotch here.
Alvarado, a real powerhouse. Credit the balance and toughness of Labastida to nullify that for the moment, but could their leg trip and down they go.
That's the second time he's laced that outside leg and parlayed it into a trip to bring the fight to the mat. Alvarado just has it on cruise control here, Todd.
This is big trouble for Labastida, Schmo, as time is a ticking.
Certainly is. This is not where you want to be. With your back on the mat, the third round, as we're approaching 2 minutes left to go of this fight. And listen, now he's got his back, he's brought it to the feet. But if I'm Alvarado, you're having the success keeping this fight on the feet, piecing him up, disengage and throw some hands.
Got to credit the toughness of Labastida, though. He has been feeling the pressure. And he's stumbling, bumbling right now. And shark smelling blood in the water, perhaps, for Alvarado. He'd love a finish if he can get it.
He's certainly biting down on his mouthpiece and throwing bombs, but he got caught on a beautiful counter takedown by Alvarado.
Powerful takedown, powerful slam there by Alvarado. Under a minute and a half to work now here to try and make history.
And so far, that's the exclamation mark on this round. Center of the cage, you got Labastida flat on his back. Let's see if he can land some ground to pound or threat with that submission.
Stepping over in the mount for a moment there, now getting back to the back.
I just really think those early takedown attempts that he just would not abandon, speaking of Labastida, are coming back to haunt him here. It just starts to lot from the gas tank.
It certainly did. You know, whenever you invest heavy on an attack that doesn't pay dividends, you risk burning yourself out. And as we saw with the strikes from Labastida as he came out, those were arm punches, Todd. He was just winging them.
Labastida didn't seem to have a plan B or C. It was plan A, which is bring this fight to the mat, get the takedown. A lot of energy, not a lot of action.
Look out here.
Alvarado threatening here.
Head and arm.
Looking to put him away by submission here. Labastida showing a lot of toughness, but how long can he last? He's got a little bit of air in there. Turning into it now. You get to this point in the fight, the sweat is flowing. Gets slippery. Labastida, man, showing his toughness. And still looking for the takedown. And he gets it. Oh, my goodness. Well,
wild.
He finally got the takedown, but perhaps too little too late. And look at the mutual respect.
Excellent scrap from two dynamic young fighters.
Great heart on the line and on display in this one. Alvarado looking to make history.
135.
In this historic fight for two titles. This way you gotta love to see, guys, the sportsmanship, a pillar of this great sport.
And boys, we got history. We got the trifecta, the state champ, the 135 pound champ, the 125 pound champ. There it is.
It sure looks that way, and we're gonna take a look back at how it all went down. Labastida exhausted. Look at that beautiful takedown there by Alvarado.
Yeah, Alvarado just implementing his will, preventing Labastida from implementing his. And he really just took him out of his game plan. Once Labastida was unable to bring that fight to the mat in the first and second round, you know, Alvarado really started to separate himself.
Picking him apart there. as you like to say, maybe a little three-piece and a biscuit there by Alvarado, and looking to change levels again. I gotta say, I did love, and maybe we'll see it, I did love the feel-good moment for Labastida to finally get that takedown in the final seconds of the fight.
It certainly was, because that's what he was hunting for all night long, and finally
there
he got
was.
That schmoment at the very end.
Yes, indeed. Back to live action. What a fight it was. What a great performance. And you got to credit Alvarado for even taking on the task of dropping a weight class as a current incumbent champion, looking to double up, triple up in this case. And history about to be made and made official. Rain Cruz is in the cage and standing by. And Labastida receiving some much-deserved respect as well.
UNF fans, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard. Judge Mike Beltran scored it 30-27. Rafael Davis, 29-28. And Chris Levin, 30-27. For your winner, for unanimous decision, and now, UNF Rising Stars Flyweight and California State Flyweight Champion, out of the red corner, Desmond Alvarado!
History made, Alvarado. And now you see it, there you see the trifecta. All three titles on display. Alvarado, he's gonna have to grow another appendage if he collects any more titles.
Desmond Alvarado, the triple crown winner here at Up Next Fighting. He's got a lot of gold around his waist there, Todd.
Ashley is standing by. Take it away,
all right,
Ashley.
I'm standing next to Daniel Labastida. That was an amazing fight, and a fight that, if you didn't tell me otherwise, I wouldn't think that that was amateur. Amazing performance. I know it's not the outcome you expected. Talk to us right now.
Desmond, he's really good at wrestling. He's not just a jiu-jitsu guy. His little, when he gets the underhooks, and he does he collects a leg with his leg. Damn, that works. I gotta start doing that.
Outside trip.
Yeah, the outside trip with the body lock. I gotta start doing that.
Well, did you learn anything today? I mean, you fought for the title. What's next for you?
Another fight, you know. But first, I need to apologize to Jose Hernandez and his team. Me and him were supposed to fight, and I had to pull out the day of the fight because my knees were blown out. I couldn't even fucking walk. So, Jose Hernandez, I know you're out there. I'm sorry for that. We can run it whenever you want. You know, if you ever need an opponent, hit me up. I'll fight you purely out of respect.
All right, let's hear it one more time. Danny Labastida. All right, here I am with your champ and new California State triple champ, flyweight and bantamweight, Rising Stars champion, Desmond Alvarado. Desmond, I gotta ask you right away, how do you stay so composed in the fire, in the middle of the third round? He's going crazy, and you are just calm as a cucumber.
I mean, I really live this life every day. I'm doing things that are constantly preparing me for here. On my rest days, I'm mentally preparing, spiritually preparing. Real quick, all glory goes to God and to the people that make sacrifices every day to get me up here. So I want to go ahead and thank those people right now. I want to thank my mom, Mindy, my girlfriend, Diana, my baby brother, Jonas, my jiu-jitsu family at Kaiki Jiu-Jitsu Wana, and all the coaches that stepped up for this camp, covering classes so me and my dad could prepare. I want to thank my family at CMMA. I know I don't tell you guys this enough, but I love you guys. I want to thank my boxing coach, Rodell Mayo, my wrestling coach, Dave Waters, and the man behind CMMA's success, and my mentor, who really, really does put these wins together. That's Chad George. He deserves so much of the glory. Thank you. I love you. And then my jiu-jitsu coach, my sensei, my partner through this every step of the way. That's my dad, Desmond Albert Alvarado. I love all of you. These guys, these are the people who made me. These are the people that make sacrifices. It's not just me making sacrifices.
We can't wait to see you in the cage again. We're going to the platform now to Schmo, who has the interviewer.
Hey, I'm here with you.